Okay, good evening. My name is Chris Stackwitz, and as you guys can probably guess, I'm an artist. Maybe not the best painter in town, as some of the comments in the South Bend Tribune will attest, but I am a painter nonetheless. More specifically, I'm that guy, the one responsible for the 933 bridge. Now, I've worked on a lot of large, grand public art projects, but never before have I had the experience of working on something like the 933 Bridge. With over 950 unique volunteers, 10,000 plus man hours, and 172,000 square feet of painted surface, I'm still reeling from the experience. However, I'm not here to speak with you tonight about the bridge itself. Rather, I'm here to discuss the concept of creating large-scale public artworks, or as some might like to call it, city beautification. When we talk about large-scale, I mean really, really big projects. We're talking bridges, roads, highways, sides of buildings big. And these surfaces in South Bend, they're begging for the HGTV treatment. So, if we consider the city our home, then perhaps we should consider how we adorn the walls of our home. Unless our aesthetic is absolutely minimal, we usually decorate it with something, something that has significance or meaning to us to give us a certain mood in particular rooms in our house. When I look at the walls and surface treatments in South Bend, I could pretty safely say that the mood that they're conveying is describable as dull. Now, most cities start with city beautification projects that begin with cleaning the city. That's just not enough. In order for a city to make it to the center pages of Better Homes and Gardens magazine, it needs to be more than just clean, it needs to be well decorated. And not just decorations anywhere, any place, they need to be strategic and placed in areas that distinguish us as a city. So thinking along these lines, let's consider the uniqueness of our neighborhoods as individual rooms within our house. Let's think of our streets as hallways within a home connected by common visual motifs. For our projects, and a number of them we've got going on, we've decided to start with something small, the entranceways or the doorways to our city. Now, when we think of the doorways to our city, what we're really talking about are critical spaces that adjust the way we feel as we move in and out of the city, as we enter and exit downtown South Bend. Now, again, I don't know about you guys, but nothing is really screaming to me. I'm excited about going into South Bend when I see crumbling concrete and rust-ridden creaking infrastructure, poison ivy, encapsulated walls. Now, the easiest solution most people have is to just put some kind of projection of our historical past up on the wall, a prototypical mural. But I think that we're better than that. I think that what we can do is project onto those spaces something that expresses the common cultural vibrancy of South Bend today. Now, these type of projects very easily can be done by corporations and really large-scale contractors, but what we focused on is including and making sure that citizens are put to use on these projects. Citizens become involved in every step of the process, from planning to painting and all steps in between. And as we've proven, to be highly successful, we need to engage our citizens with corporations and charities. Now, when citizens have the opportunity to become involved in physically shaping the space in which they live, to paint the surfaces of the walls they call their home, they take a small but significant sense of ownership with them. That sense of ownership gives us pride of place, and we protect and preserve that area. Now, we've worked with local neighborhoods to identify artists within the areas so that we can get them to join in on the project. Those artist types stand out, and they're not always your sweet and gentle watercolor painter, but what they're looking for are opportunities to express themselves that are bigger than the tag they can create on the wall in an hour. So what we're trying to do is create a critical mass of artists to employ as a new labor force in South Bend to begin the redecoration process. We've provided students and other artists with apprenticeships, internships, vocational opportunities, and even employment opportunities. We have a number of big projects lined up in the near future. We're looking at doing the big gray wall across from Century Center. And next Memorial Day, we plan on starting this, the Howard Park Pedestrian Bridge. Contact us for more information. Enjoy the rest of the evening, and thank you.